While there are more and more countries lining up to attract Indian tourists, the ongoing boycott by Indian social media users of countries which spoke against India at the UNGA has not come down yet. Will the tourist destinations like Turkey and Malaysia regret their so-called anti-India stance at the UNGA? And will the passion of the Indian social media users manifest into something that can actually trouble the boycotted nations? A travel advisory for Indian citizens has been issued by the Indian embassy in Turkey. The embassy encourages travelers to use extreme caution when visiting due to Ankara's continued military operation in northeastern Syria. According to credited sources, there have been several Indian tourists that have reported that they were concerned over the diminishing security in Turkey as a result of the trans-border military operation in Syria. It is also worth pointing out that earlier, through an official statement, India had asked Ankara to respect Syria's territorial rights and jurisdiction. Many other countries have had to issue similar advisories to that of the one issued by India for travelers visiting Turkey. Earlier, it was also reported that the Indian Prime Minister has temporarily halted his planned visit to Ankara. More and more Indian tourists are going abroad and are presenting a great business opportunity to various global tourist destinations. India is experiencing rapid increases in outbound tourism, ranking only behind China in the tourism market. India is expected to average an astounding 50 million outbound tourists by 2020, according to the United Nations World Tourism Organization. India's prospering middle class is one of the key factors in this tremendous growth in international outbound travel. In just 10 years, Indians doubled the amount of money that they spend while traveling abroad. Statistics show that from 2005 to 2015, the spending increased from $7.5 billion to close to $16 billion. This increase in the amount of outbound travel has been noticed by the national tourist organizations of many countries, and their offices are being placed throughout India to bring more publicity to Indians who are interested in going for a foreign tour. The Tourism Authority of Thailand and Bangkok Airways have come together to create a campaign called Fly Me to Thailand that is aimed at impressing and attracting Indian tourists. An announcement by the President of Brazil, Jair Bolsonaro, declared his intention to put new measures into place that will create a more substantial contact with India. Visa requirements for the citizens of India will no longer be necessary. This new policy that is in the works by Brazil will provide Indian travelers faster access to their country. So, are Turkey and Malaysia making a big mistake? See you again.